Little class, let's take a look at the next drawing, which is a triangular ramp with a notch and holes. My strategy will be using symmetry mirroring to draw half of the drawing and then reflect it so that the other half is present. So let's take a look. These are some of the dimensions. I notice that the square down low here, right in here, is missing a dimension there. So I'm going to call the height of this particular view 150, based on this dimension here of 50. Assuming this is also 50, and the bottom portion here is 50, which makes the whole thing 150. Okay. All right. So I'll take my front view. It's where I want to start. And I'm going to draw the triangular shape feature. Click on the front view plane. Take the line tool. Let's draw my triangle. So this way. Move across. Across this way. And I'll dimension that. So what are those dimensions? Well, let's take a look. It's 110. Since this is 220, half of that is also 110. Okay. 110 by 110. I could use the equal constraint. It's also fine. But I want to give myself the ability to change the constraint if necessary. All right. There you go. Very nice. What else do I want to add? This notch here up top. I'm going to add that as well. You can see it here as well. It's a square. So I'm going to draw half of that triangle here. Okay, so it's going to show up right here. Now that is size-wise, let's see. 20 by 20, okay. And when you take a square and divide it from its opposite diagonals, you form a 90 degree 45-45 right triangle. So the legs are congruent. The geometry theorem, the legs of a isosceles triangle are congruent. And since it's a 45-45-90, the base angles are congruent, so it's isosceles triangle. So like I said, this was 20. Let's draw a segment here. From here to here, let's make this 20. So I'm going to click there. I'm going to constrain this to be 20. And now I'm going to snap it right. Well, even if I didn't constrain it, watch this. Let's see if I can do this. Let's say if I just place it somewhere. Well, I placed it here properly. All right. So let's see if that's correct. That's a little off. Let me try that again. Try that one more time. So I want to select it here. I want to make sure it's 45. So that's 45. So let's say it's connected right there. Okay, now it says it was 19. Let's dimension it. 20. And it kind of moved that angle a little bit, which I didn't want to see, so let's see if I can change this angle here. It's 45. There we go. All right, excellent. And actually, I want to make that 90. Let's change that again. There we go. All right, that's right. Okay, perfect. So that's a 90 degree right triangle here. Constrains this so that this is 20, it's also 20. It's like there, and it's perfect. It's that notch. A little tricky there. Might not make a whole lot of sense on how I did that, but yeah, check that out. Good stuff. Now, what else am I going to add to this diagram? Well, one more peek. I'm going to add this portion right in here. See it? Add that piece. So what I know is, so I'm going just half of it because I'm going to use symmetry to create the other half. The whole thing is 380, right? And this is 220. And so what's the remainder there? 160? Yeah, 160. So these two segments here, when you sum them together, 160, which means each piece must be 180. Or 80, I'm sorry. This must be 80, right? 80. So do some math there, calculate it, see if you can figure out why it's 80. Let's draw this down. And what's the other height of this here? 35? I've got this. 35. So let's go here. At 80. This is 35. Is that right? So this here is a little off. I wanted it to be. I want this to be 35, not 5. There we go. Not bad. So I think I have everything I need. Let's take a look. Yeah, things are looking good. So what I'm going to do now is extrude. Now, I want you to pay attention here. When I extrude, I'm going to extrude using symmetry, and it's going to extrude in both directions, the front side and the back side. And when I extrude that, the distance of that extrude is going to be, based on this diagram here, 150, okay? And the extrude here is going to be 55, all right? So let's take a rotation here. Shift on the keyboard, hold down the wheel, the mouse, rotate that just a hair, just finish the sketch. Let's go to extrude, click on this here and here, and I'm going to extrude this by 150. So watch this. It says one side, let's choose symmetry. Let's choose the measurement as the whole length. Let's make this number 150. And there it is. So do you see what's going on there? See all that? That triangle there's been extruded both on both sides, front and back. Total of 150. Perfect. Okay. Now my next step is to extrude this piece here. Right, so let's just go okay, pick another extrude, and then we're going to extrude this other piece, but it disappeared on me, which means that you have to go to the sketch folder here in your browser, poke the eye so that you can see it, and there you go, this is going to be 55. Again, you want symmetry, measurement is the whole length. Make this 55. Excellent. Okay. All right, so I like what I see so far. Shift, push the wheel down on the mouse. There you go. Now this notch here that I'm gonna remove, let me show it to you. Right up in here. I'm going to remove that notch. It's going to be half of it. You see that right in here? It's that triangular piece I'm going to remove. It's going to be removed. So it's that extrude removal feature. All right? So let's take the extrude button again. I'm going to select this piece here, but you notice that all of the faces are being activated and I can't seem to find that. So what you end up doing is there is a body folder here on the browser section here. See this? Anyway, you poke the eye of the body. It hides it. Now you can click that triangular region. It activates it. I want operations to be cut. Okay, and let's see what the numbers, what size it is. Here it says it's 50. That's the size of the cut. Okay. We'll use a symmetric cut. So it's going to be symmetric, total length. Okay. Make this 50. Tab on the keyboard. And if the cut is there, you just can't see it because the body's been hidden. So here, it says body. Let's click on the eye. That red feature. Okay. And that's been cut. Shift, wheel, rotate. So I no longer need the sketch to be seen. So I can poke the eye of the sketch. It disappears. All right, now I want to draw the circle here on the top portion, that circle. And that circle has a diameter of 20. And the center of that circle, how do you find that? Well, there it is. It's over here. It's 20 by 27 and a half, okay? Okay, 20 by 27 and a half. All right. Back here, new sketch. Click the face here, and circle tool. This 20. Click. Put this one now. Make sure that's where it's supposed to be at. Yeah. Now I want to move that around, right? Center it. I go to my dimension tool. Click on the center. On the bottom half, and that's supposed to be 27.5, right? All right, let's go enter. And now from here, the center point to the outer edge here, that's supposed to be 20. And we're looking good. Escape on the keyboard. And I need to save this drawing, don't I? Let me save this here. Go save. First period. Right. And this is the triangular ramp with notch. Holes, not using Camelback correctly, and holes video. Right, so let's take that hole, extrude it, accept the sketch, extrude, click on that, let's go to cut, and let's go all the way through. I think it went all the way through. Yeah, I think that's it. Let's see. Let's go to the home button. And we're looking good. All right. Now we're going to go to mirror. Go to create. Is there a mirror button? There it is, mirror. All right. So we're going to select the body. It's the whole body. One body here. See? We select the body. It says mirror plane. Now select a mirror plane. I'm going to select this plane here. I think it just kind of mirrors it across that plane. So select that, and there it is. But does it mirror it correctly? Try a different plane. Let's go OK. And there you have it. So that is the object. All done. Looks fine, looks symmetric. All right, like I always say, study hard and learn a lot. See you soon. Bye-bye.